गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल स्टडी लेक्चर 3 टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस। टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस इन अल्कलाइन C-H बॉन्ड इज पोलर। वी आर टोल्ड बिफोर ड्यू टू इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट हैलोजन विड्रॉज इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर टुवर्ड्स इट्स ओन साइड एंड मेक्स कार्बन इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफिशिएंट। दैट मींस कार्बन इज मेकिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन डिफिशिएंट मींस इट इज हैविंग इट विल एक्वायर पॉजिटिव चार्ज, हेंस इट बिकम्स गुड टारगेट फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनर। That is, it becomes nucleophile. In this reaction, OH minus is nucleophile. This is attacking group and bromine is leaving group. This is nucleophilic substitution reaction. So we are seeing nucleophile here due to inductive effect, X is getting removed and carbon is getting positive charge. And this is nucleophile is negatively charged and this nucleophile is attacking on this carbon because it is having positively charged. And this X is removed. And here again example, here if bromine is there and the presence of NaOH, OH minus is the nucleophile, it is attacking on carbon and bromine is removed. So you are getting here alkyl halide, you are getting alcohol. So from alkyl halide you are getting alcohol by this type of reaction. Depending upon the number of molecules participating in the rate determining step, nucleophilic substitution reactions are of three types. They are SN1 reaction, SN2 and SNI reaction. In SN1 reaction means substitution nucleophilic unimolecular, SN2 reaction is substitution nucleophilic bimolecular, SNI is internal or intramolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. So these three types of reactions are there, nucleophilic SN1, SN2 and SNI reaction. So we will study SN1 reaction, substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. Reaction is having two step, it is a two step reaction. In the first step, heterolytic fusion is taking place, that is C-X bond breaks and carbon is getting positive charge and halogen is getting negative charge. This type of fusion is known as heterolytic fusion. Only one molecule is involved in this step, hence it is known as unimolecular. Why it is called unimolecular? Because only one molecule is involved in this reaction, so it is known as unimolecular reaction. In the second step, OH minus nucleophile attack on positively charged carbonic ion and replacement of halogen by OH nucleophile takes place. Example, hydrolysis of tertiary butyl bromide in the presence of NaOH. So this is tertiary butyl bromide in the presence of sodium hydroxide. We are getting tertiary butyl alcohol plus Br minus. This is the main reaction. Next step, we are studying the its mechanism. SN1 reaction mechanism is in this step stable carbonium ion is formed. We are seeing tertiary butyl bromide, this is a slow step and Br minus is getting removed and carbon is getting positively charged. This is carbonium ion is formed, tertiary carbonium ion is formed. This is the intermediate product. This is the first step, what is happening? Stable carbonium ion is formed. In this step OH minus attack, in the second step OH minus attack from both sides of the carbonium ion because this planar molecule and tertiary alcohol racemic mixture is formed. So this is tertiary carbonium ion is a planar molecule and so OH minus is attacking from both these sides and you are getting racemic mixture of tertiary butyl alcohol. Racemic mixture means equimolecular mixture of dextro and levorotatory product is there and you are getting the racemic mixture. Dextrorotatory and levorotatory product is there and you are getting this both are known as racemic mixture is formed in this SN1 mechanism. In the step 1, carbonium ion is formed and in the step 2, attack of OH minus from both these sides to give racemic mixture of tertiary alcohol. This is the energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. You are seeing that in the first we are getting tertiary butyl bromide in the presence of OH minus, it is having lower energy, then the energy increases and here you are getting here the peak is there and again you are getting intermediate carbonium ion is formed at this stage. It means when carbonium ion is formed the energy is lesser. Then again the second step is little slower and then here again the product is formed. This is product is racemic mixture. Equimolecular proportion of dextro and levorotatory product is known as racemic mixture. So here the product is mixture and it is having lower energy than the reactants. Reactants are having little more energy and see here you are seeing that level is somewhat down than this product. So tertiary butyl bromide in the presence of NaOH you are getting racemic mixture of tertiary butyl alcohol. Thank you.